Hello students, today we will discuss graph algorithm. It is also known as graph theory, where we can find out the properties of graph structure. When we are going to find out in the properties of graph structure, it basically deals with the solving the problems of graph, where it's going to be underlying certain situations. So for that we can use a classical algorithms. So in that we are going to be find out degree properties. So basically when we are dealing with degree properties, it's nothing but to find out the graph degree, where the number of edges which are incident on the vertices. So that will be the degree of graph. So hence, if I am going to be find out the degree of graph for undirected graph, is nothing but sum of the vertices, sum of the vertex degree, which is the twice the number of edges, since every edge is contribute one of the degree of the both adjacent vertices. That means it is nothing but the number of edges which are going from the or coming to the edge from the adjacent vertices will be the degree of undirected graph. Similarly, if I find directed graph degree, is the degree condition is that sum of the in degrees of all the vertices equal to the sum of all the out degrees. Means in vertices and out edges from the vertices are going to be equal. And if I am going to find out the degree for the tree, which is undirected graph, which contains no cycle. So for that, the vertex degree are important in the analysis of the tree. A leaf of the tree of vertex, for vertex 1, the vertex of degree 1, every n vertex degree contain n minus 1 edges. So non-traversal tree contain at least 2 of the leaf vertices. Next is connectivity. So connectivity is nothing but the number of edges are representing or coming or going from the vertices. So mainly it is going to be consist of a spanning tree is sufficient to prove the connectivity. So all the spanning tree which are representing the connectivity. Cycles in the graph, all non-traversal non-tree connected graph contain cycle, particularly inserting, intersecting R cycles which visit all edges or vertex of the graph. Next is planar graph. So planar graph are those which can drawn in the plane such that no two edges crosses each others. In the planar tree, no two edges will be crossing to the each other. Hence here the tree are the best example to represent about the planar tree, where no two edges are crossing each others. In regard with this, we are going to be seeing the example or with the concept is minimum spanning tree. It is also called as a prism algorithm or Kruschel algorithm, where the spanning tree is representation of a graph which having a set of edges from E forming a tree connecting all vertices of V. For edge-weighted graph, we are particularly interested in minimum spanning tree. That minimum spanning tree whose sum of the edge weight is the smallest possible, where In the spanning tree, we are interested to find out minimum ages, weight, graph, which will find you the idea about minimum or the smallest possible weight. So minimum spanning tree is answer where to find out to connect a number of a set of points, which may be we going to be find out the representing of cities, junctions or other location where the smallest amount of roadways, wires or the pipe are going to be connected between the cities and the junctions. It is not only limited for the cities and junctions. We can able to find out minimum networks, minimum flow within the programs, minimum sequence of the statements are also going to be find out by using the minimum spanning tree. Well, any tree is the smallest possible connected graph in terms of number of ages, while minimum spanning tree is the smallest connected graph in terms of weight, age weight. So here we'll see one example which is represented for the spanning tree. I have a graph of 1 is connected with the 2, 2 is connected with the 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5 and 5 to 1. So here this graph is consists of 5 nodes which are connected with the edges. So this graph I can represent with the G of V, E. If I want to represent the spanning tree for this graph, I will represent this is with G dash of V dash, E dash is nothing but a spanning tree. So if I want to compare the edges and the vertex of graph and the spanning tree, I will say V dash is equal to V, that is vertex of spanning tree are equal to the vertex of graph. But if I want to represent the edges of spanning tree and the graph, where the E dash is a subset of E, that means the edges of spanning tree is a subset of edges of graph, either I can represent E dash equal to V minus 1. That means edges of spanning tree are nothing but vertex of graph minus 1. So we'll see about the how I can represent the spanning tree for the graph. This is one possibility where I can represent the spanning tree from this graph. Another possibility is this one, that is 1 is connected with the 5, 5 with the 4, 4 with the 3 and 3 with the 2. Another possibility is that 1 is connected with the 2, 2 with the 3, 3 with the 4 and 4 with the 5. These are the spanning tree which are going to be represent for this graph. But if I say that the graph is weighted graph, then what are the possibility we can able to represent for the spanning tree? So this is what the same graph, but which will the edges are considered the weight. Here the weight is for 2 to 1 is 1, 2 to 3 is 4, 3 to 4, 3 to 4 is 5, 4 to 5 is 2 and 5 to 3 is 3. So what will be the spanning tree? What are the possibility to represent the spanning tree if the weight, the weighted graph? So this is the first which I are going to be seeing here. If I going to be see about the first spanning tree, the weight will be 12. For the second, it will be of 14. For third, it will be of 11. Where for the fourth, you will see that weight of this graph is 10. So this fourth one will be the spanning tree which is represented for the weighted graph of this example. Thank you.